A very good morning, children, and welcome back to the computer class. Today we will continue with the fourth chapter, that is keyboard, special keys. And in the previous class I had given a brief introduction about the keyboard, and we all know that keyboard is an important input device of computer. We give instructions to the computer with the help of keyboard, and it has many keys on it. As you all know that a keyboard has many keys. These are the different keys. Now these keys, they can be differentiated, or they can be categorized in different categories. They are these keys which have letters on them, which have alphabets on them, they are called alphabet keys. The keys which have numbers on them, they are called number keys, and there are some special keys also. Now how does a keyboard work? If I will press any key, suppose I have pressed here K E Y B O A R D, and on the monitor you can see that keyboard has been typed. Similarly, if you want to type numbers, so you have to press the number keys. Number keys are present at two places. One is at the top of the alphabet keys, and other, as I told you last time also, at the right hand side, which is called the numeric keypad. Now if you want to type numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so you can type from here. As you can see on the screen also, the numbers have come. And if you want to type from here, even from here you can type. See, again they have come here. So these are the special keys. Special keys or symbols. First we will do the symbols. What are symbols? At the top of these number keys you can see there are some symbols made. In order to type these symbols, we have to type them with the help of pressing a shift key. Now this is shift key. This usually shift is written, but in this particular brand of the keyboard, shift is not written. The arrow head, which is pointing upward, this is the shift key. There are two shift keys on the keyboard, one on the left side and the other one on the right side. Now I can show that in the keyboard of laptop, here the shift is written. See, you can recognize it with the help of this symbol, which is pointing, the arrow is pointing towards up, shift key, and one more, this is the shift key. So by pressing shift key and this sign of exclamation, if I want, I will press this and I will keep it pressed here. So here you can see that the sign of exclamation, or if I want to type at the rate sign, so again I will press shift key and 2. Why 2? Because at the top of 2 this at the rate sign is there. So these both keys I will press simultaneously. Simultaneously means at the same time, one and then another one. See, here at the rate sign has come. So this is how you can type the symbols which are present on the number keys. There are 10 number keys, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 0. Now if you want to type 10, then you have to first press 1 and then you will press 10. See here, the number 10 has come. If you want to type a longer number, suppose I want to type 4, 5, 6, 7. So here 4567 has come. So there are 10 number keys, 26 alphabet keys. Now we will be learning spacebar key. What is a spacebar key? The spacebar key is the longest key on the keyboard. It is used to give spaces between the text. First I will show you the spacebar key. This is the spacebar key, the longest key on the keyboard. The longest key on the keyboard, and this is used to give spaces. How? Suppose I write here, my name is Kabir. Now here you can see that there is no space. When you write in the notebook, you give space between two letters or two words, but here there is no space. So in order to give space, we have to press the spacebar key. How? We will bring our cursor here and then I will press the spacebar key once. And see, here we can have the space, we can see the space. After name, again I need the space, I will press it here. Again after is. Now it is not that you have to type and then later on you will give spaces. You will give space after writing every word, like I space am space learning space computer and full stop, right? So you have understood the function of spacebar key. Next we will be learning caps lock key. Caps lock key is used to type letters in capitals. Press the caps lock key once, the caps lock light will turn on. If you remember last time I told you that there are certain indicators here and they get lighted when certain keys are pressed. Now this is the key or the indicator for the caps lock. Here we have caps lock. What is the function of caps lock? If I will press this caps lock, the light here will turn on and now I can write whatever I want to type. I can type it in capital. See, earlier we were typing in small letters. Now since this caps lock is on, now we will be able to type in capital letters. How? I am a good child, full stop, right? So this is the caps lock function, key function of caps lock key. Now if you want to close this caps lock, means if you want to type in small abc in lowercase. Lowercase is, this is called lowercase in the language of computer. This is called lowercase and this is called uppercase. Now again I will press this caps lock key once again and here the light turns off, gets off. Now if you want to type, you will type in small. I am a good child. So this is the function of caps lock key. Next we have the enter key. Enter key is used to bring the cursor to the next line on the monitor. A keyboard has two enter keys. Now enter key, there are two enter keys on a keyboard. One is this is the sign of enter key, and another one is on the numeric keypad. This is the enter key. What is the function of enter key? If you will press enter key, the cursor will come to the next line. See here, if I press this enter key, see what happens to the cursor. It will come to the next line. Now suppose anything I type, again I press this enter key and see, the cursor will come to the next line. So this is the function of enter key. For today we will be doing this much only. Rest of the keys we will be taking up in the next class. We will be learning in the next class. Now students, I'll be sending you some question answers also. Those question answers you have to write in your notebook, and for the next week be prepared with the test. Whatever question answers will be given, prepare them side by side for the text next week.